Hi everybody, welcome back to the Front Room. I'm Kai and I'm here with my dad today.
Hi guys, thanks for joining us again. Big day.
It's a big day.
Big day.
Yeah, it's a Nas day.
Nas
it's an
day.
Illmatic day.
Yeah, it's a first full album reaction day.
Yeah, all those things.
Yeah, yeah. Well, I'm really super looking forward to this.
Yeah.
I don't really know what to expect here.
Mm-hmm.
But you've told me he's like super highly regarded, so...
Super, especially this album.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, I wanted to show you this full album rather than just a song.
Is this his first album?
This is his first album.
Oh, great.
Yeah.
I like to start at the source.
Yeah, it's always nice.
Yeah.
Unless it's bad.
Yeah.
Then maybe you want to go to the other stuff, and then if you're a fan, then you go back
and
hear it.
Yeah, I've done that with lots of artists, actually.
Yeah, me too.
You know, I've been enjoying all the rap you've been showing me, having me listen to. It's all been fantastic. Starting to get a sense of what it's all about at a very, you know, basic level, I guess. So I'm wondering how he will add to that, add to my appreciation of the whole genre.
Yeah, well, I bet there will be quite a lot of stuff to talk about throughout this album.
Good.
And just so I mentioned it now, we created a Patreon account, which is somewhere that people, fans of the channel, can go to and subscribe to pledge a certain amount of money.
Like we have three tiers, right?
We have three tiers, yeah.
Yeah.
Different perks per tier.
Yeah.
But the most basic one, just for $3 a month, you can get all of our uncut album reactions, which is, I think, what a lot of people want. So, so if you really enjoy our content, we would appreciate it a lot if you might consider checking out the Patreon and...
Yeah, please check it out.
Because of copyright, we can't get any money from YouTube so far.
Mm-hmm.
I think we've made $4.
Yeah, I think there was one video really, really early on that was not copyright blocked.
Yeah.
Out of all of them.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think we've made about
$4 total.
I think $4.02, I think. Actually.
Yeah.
Yeah. And I want to say, actually, thank you guys for cutting me some slack with my reactions to this rap. It's a totally new world for me, and I'm sure I make all sorts of mistakes, and I miss tons of stuff. And you guys in the comments are often telling me, well, you know, this actually meant that, or you could have added that. And so
me as well.
Through your comments, I'm actually, and I think you too, to a certain degree.
Oh yeah, totally.
We're sort of building our understanding of the whole genre and the artists. So really appreciate that. Yeah.
Yeah, so it's Nas.
Okay.
I showed you Rakim last video.
Yeah.
Well, maybe when this goes up, it might be a couple of videos ago, but very recently.
Mm-hmm.
And we haven't done a lot of East Coast rap from New York especially.
Mm-hmm.
So I wanted to give you that early taste of that Rakim, who completely reinvented the wheel in terms of flow, in terms of word choice, and in terms of calmly delivering his raps.
Right.
And this is, I sort of strategically showed you that before this album. Because Nas takes what Rakim did and brings it to a new level.
Well, that's what art is all about, taking what was done previously and modifying it and adding to it. And that's what it's all about, right?
Yeah, totally.
Yeah.
So that's why this album is considered to be so great by so many. A lot of people think it's the best rap album of all time.
Really?
Of all time, yeah.
So like better than a Kanye album?
Yeah, a lot of people.
Wow, okay.
Nas is from Queensbridge in New York, I think, by Long Island.
I haven't heard of Queensbridge. I've heard of Queens.
Yeah.
But, okay.
And, this album came out in 94.
Mm-hmm.
It's legendary.
Can I grab it?
Yeah, you can grab it.
So, is this him as a little kid?
Yeah, that's him at...
Okay, because it has that... old photograph, sepia color to it. It looks like it would be a picture of him, probably.
Yeah, this album released when he was 20 years old, and it was written from when he was 16 or 17, sort of debated, to 19 and 20.
He was how old when he released this?
20.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Young.
Yes, and the photo on the cover is when he was 7, and he chose that picture from when he was 7 because he thought that that's when his world completely changed at that age.
In what sense?
He began to see a future for himself
and
started to understand that there was more to the world than just his small community. And before, when he felt boxed in, he realized there was a land of opportunity.
Okay. Well, I guess when you're 7, 8, 9, you sort of start to clue into the fact the world is a bit bigger than what you thought it was.
Yeah.
And you're more aware of things going on.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So without further ado, shall we
Let's get it.
All right. The first song is called The Genesis. In the background, he has a track playing, his first ever recorded sort of professional rap verse is playing in the background. And you also hear, well, I won't tell you that, but you also hear some dialogue from a movie from 83, which is the very first movie to really discuss hip hop. I haven't seen it myself, but it's very important in that sense. So he takes a sample from his own music, from when he started, and also from when sort of hip hop started in the visual sense and in that media form of movies. So that's why. Here we go, The Genesis.
And you're sitting at home doing this shit? And you should be honoring a medal for this. Stop fucking around and be a man. There ain't nothing out here for you.
I like that. You know how we get down, baby.
So the creepy seven.
Niggas don't listen, man. Representing is Illmatic.
That was good. Yeah. That was so cool. The whole beat, that and there's some sort of high tone of percussion going.
Yeah.
Really cool.
Sounds like some sort of like a tom or like a woodblock
sound. Yeah, right. Exactly, yeah. What I liked about this was you hear train tracks. You hear a train rolling down the tracks. So that made me think, since there's a picture of him as a kid on the cover, and the back kind of looks like some kind of rundown area, maybe, I guess, of New York. When I heard those tracks, I thought to myself, maybe this is, I'm guessing he lived on what is called, used to be called the wrong side of the tracks, just meaning that poorer people lived on one side, I think usually the east side of railroad tracks for some reason. So when I heard that, and then these guys talking, like they're just sort of hanging out, it made me think, it's introducing you into his world. Like you've gone across the tracks into his world or something.
Yeah.
So really visual to me.
Yeah, that's a good point.
Like why else would he have the sound of train tracks? That's from his environment.
Yeah, totally.
Right?
Totally.
What does Illmatic mean?
Illmatic means beyond, well, it has two possible meanings that I think Nas said, beyond ill or the ultimate. So ill in the sense it's just slang for what I consider to be like cool someone that has good technique, being a rapper. In this sense.
Right.
So they're beyond cool.
Right.
Or the ultimate, if that's the meaning of Illmatic, that could just mean that this is like the ultimate album. This is like it. Okay. In some sense.
Okay.
Yeah. So the next song is New York State of Mind.
New York State of Mind. Okay.
And this is one of his most popular songs. Very, very iconic song. And it carries on some of the atmosphere from the introduction track, The Genesis. So here we go.
Okay.
Yeah. And yo, Black, it's time. Word. Straight out the fucking dungeons of rap, where fake niggas don't make it back. I don't know how to start this shit.
I don't know how to start this shit.
Rappers are monkey flipping with the funky rhythm. I be kicking, musician, inflicting composition of pain. I'm like Scarface sniffing cocaine, holding an M16. See, with the pen, I'm extreme. Now,
bullet holes left in my peepholes. I'm suited up with street clothes. Hand me a 9 and out the feet froze. So now I'm jetting to the building lobby. And it was full of children, probably couldn't see as high as I be. It's like the game ain't the same. Got younger niggas pulling the triggers, bringing fame to their name and claim some corners. Crews without guns or corners. In broad daylight, stick up kids, they run up on us. 4-5s and gauges, max and facts. Same niggas that catch you back to back, catching your cracks in black. There was a snitch on the block, getting niggas knocked. So hold your stash to the coke price drop. I know this crackhead who says she gotta smoke nice rock. And if it's good, you bring your customers and measuring plots. But yo, it drops deep as it does in my breath. I never sleep, cause sleep is the cousin of death. Beyond the walls of intelligence, life is divine. I think of crime when I'm in a New York state of mind. State of mind.
Yeah. Well, there's just so, I mean, there's so many lyrics.
Yeah.
Can I talk about this?
Yeah, of course.
Yeah. Wonderful beat and that. Dun, 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 dun. I don't know if that's a piano or what. But
yeah, it's a piano.
It's really kind of dangerous sounding.
Yeah, it is.
Know?
It is.
Yeah. So he's describing his life on the street, right?
Yeah, I heard you sort of.
Yeah.
Make a sound at I never sleep because sleep is the cousin of death.
Yeah, yeah. So does that mean that living in such a tough environment, dangerous, you don't dare sleep or you don't dare put your guard down or something like that?
Exactly.
Yeah. Okay.
The type of brother made for you to start testing. Give me a Smith and Wesson, I have niggas undressing. Thinking of cash flow, Buddha and shelter. Whenever frustrated, I'm a hijack Delta. And the PJs, my blend tape plays, bullets are straight. I'm an addict for sneakers, 20s a Buddha and bitches with beepers. In the streets, I could greet ya. About blunts, I teach ya. Inhale deep, like the words in my breath. I never sleep, cause sleep is the cousin of death. I lay puzzle as I backtrack to earlier times. Nothing's equivalent to the New York state of mind. State of mind.
I like that. I lay puzzled as I backtrack to earlier times. He's only 20, but he's reminiscing on the past and sort of just trying to figure it out, but is confused of how it all works because his situation was and is just so overwhelming to think of all these things.
Nothing's equivalent to the New York state of mind, so is he saying there that, I don't quite get it, but
he's just saying that this particular circumstance that he's in Queensbridge and for other people in New York, more generally, he's saying that the conditions that we are put in this place will not be felt in the same way as do other people feel in their environment. It's a unique state of mind that you develop from being exposed to these things.
Oh, I see. Okay. I'm living where the nights is jet black. And fiends fine to get crack. It's just it's so vivid, you know, the imagery.
Yeah.
Yeah. I almost feel like I'm right in there with him, looking over my shoulder.
Yeah.
Or something.
Yeah, totally. I agree. I think the music reinforces that as well.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Yeah, definitely. I love the music. It's very foreboding. Like, it's like, okay, what's going to happen? Type of a feel to it. He mentions Buddha several times.
Yeah, that's just a slang for weed.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, so and later on you'll also hear that the word lie L-Y-E.
Yeah.
That just for means weed. Yeah.
Lie? Okay.
Yeah, but this next song
I like that a lot. That's good. Yeah,
I like this next song even more. It's called Life's a Bitch. Here we go.
I'm saying that's what this is all about, right? Clothes, bank rolls, and holes, you know what I'm saying? Yo, then what?
Like
man?
That.
Visualizing the realism of life and actuality. Fuck who's the baddest. A person's status depends on salary. And my mentality is money orientated. I'm destined to live the dream for all my peeps who never made it. Even though we know somehow we all gotta go. But as long as we leave in thieving, we'll be leaving with some kind of dough. So until the day we expire and turn to vapors, me and my capers, I'll be somewhere stacking plenty papers. Keeping it real, packing, still getting high. Cause life's a bitch and then you die.
Bye.
Yeah.
My skull, cause it's pain in my brain, vein, money maintained. No go against the grain, simple
so
and plain. When I was younger, this I used to do my thing hard. Robbing foreigners, take their wallets, their jewels, and rip their green cards.
Yeah.
To the project flashing, my
take
quick cash.
And
got my first piece of ass, smoking blunts with hash.
Life's a bitch, and then you die. That's why we get high, cause you never know when you're gonna go. Life's a bitch, and then you die. That's why we puff fly, cause you never know when you're gonna go.
Catchy,
life's
yeah, chord.
Yeah. I love how he just belts it out. Even his voice is pretty raspy and sort of thin in a way.
Yeah, it's thin to me, but
yeah, but he's yelling it, so it doesn't sound like an outright yell, but you can hear that he's really, really putting his heart and soul
you
into
can.
It.
Yeah, you can, yeah. He's almost straining a little bit, like
yeah.
wants to get it out, tell
yeah.
you this.
Totally.
Yeah. Trumpet, I like that.
Yeah. This is Oludara. Who was Nas's dad?
His father.
Playing here, yeah.
Oh, yeah. Wow.
Yeah.
Oh. Comes from a musical family. Or his
yeah.
dad, at least.
Yeah.
Yeah. That was pretty short. I like this. So it sounds like here he's bragging about... well, okay. Let me see if I can go back and find the stuff that I really
yeah.
liked. My mentality is money-orientated. I'm destined to live the dream for all my peeps, my friends who never made it.
He's wanting to do the best for the people that weren't able to do their best, whether they didn't have the right opportunities or they were incarcerated or anything in between. He's realizing that he has this opportunity. So he's going to live his dream
mm-hmm.
on behalf of people that weren't able to. That's the way I see it. I love AZ's verse in the beginning, his voice, the way he just attacks it. Straight away, pretty quickly.
Uh-huh.
I think that was effective, and it's an amazing verse. And he's talking a lot about how, you know, like, and when AZ and Nas are talking at the beginning of the song, he says, you know, I'm separating this money. Let's get this money. I'm gonna put the grants over there in the safe. The Washingtons go to wifey. He's saying,
what is he talking about? Then?
How to divide his money, where to put it.
That's money.
Yeah.
Okay.
Like Washington, George Washington, like a certain type of bill.
Oh yeah, okay.
Right.
All right. Oh, I see. Okay.
Yeah, so he's saying how to divide his money, and
yeah.
he's saying, this is what it's all about, clothes, bankrolls, and hoes. You know what I'm saying? So he's saying that really, like, what he wants to do is get money and
yeah.
enjoys life.
Yeah.
But I think where Nas sort of switches that around is in his verse, and he realizes that it's not all about just having pleasures. With the line, I switched my motto. Instead of saying fuck tomorrow, that buck that could have bought the bottle could have struck the lotto. So he's saying, instead of saying fuck tomorrow, where he once didn't care about what was going to happen to him the next day because he's just enjoying it, or maybe he just doesn't care at all about anything, he realizes that some things are actually important. You should save your money
mm-hmm.
and put it towards something that could reap a greater benefit.
Mm-hmm. Although lottery tickets are pretty
yeah.
unsure.
Yeah, totally. I think he just meant to say that some things could just have a big reward.
Yeah, yeah. Instead of spending all your money on booze, you know, put
yeah.
some aside and do something better with it, I
yeah.
guess. Yeah.
The fourth track
mm-hmm.
is called The World Is Yours.
The World Is Yours.
Yeah.
Okay. The world is your oyster. Maybe you can do whatever you want with the world.
Yeah, we'll see.
Maybe.
You'll see.
That's my prediction.
This is one of my first Nas songs, so
oh.
it has a special place in my heart, I suppose.
Right.
Ready?
Yeah. Jazzy.
Yep.
Whose world is this?
The world is yours. I sip the dumb peak, watching Gandhi till I'm charged and writing in my book of rhymes, all the words past the margin. The whole of mic, I'm throbbing. Mechanical movement, understandable smooth shit that murderers move with. The thief's theme,
the thief's
play
theme.
Me at night, they won't act right. The fiend of hip hop has got me stuck like a crack pipe. The mind activation, react like I'm facing time like Pappy Mason. With pins, I'm embracing, wipe the. I keep falling, but never falling 6 feet deep. I'm out for presidents to represent me.
Say what?
I'm out for presidents to represent me. Me.
Say what?
I'm out for dead presidents to represent me.
Whose world is this?
The world is yours. The world is yours.
It's mine. It's mine. It's mine. Whose world
percussion's quite bouncy.
Yeah, I like that. Mm-hmm. Good groove. You mentioned the jazzy piano.
Yeah,
this album uses a lot of different samples and a variety of styles, like avant-garde jazz. It's not just stuff.
The versatile honey sticking wild golden child dwelling in the rotten apple. You get tackled, a caught by the devil's lasso. Shit is a hassle. There's no days for broke days. We sell a smoke pays while all the old folks pray to Jesus soaking their sins in trays.
I love this chorus. It's
good. It's Nas and Pete Rock. Pete Rock is a legendary producer. He did a lot of the production himself. This is some of the smoothest scratching.
That's scratching. From this era. Sounds like chipmunks from the old cartoon.
I love when scratching.
Sorry, what? Single-handed for murder raps. I kick my thoughts alone, get remanded. The world is yours. Everybody at Mount Vernon. The world is yours. Long Island. Yo, the world is yours. Staten Island. Yeah, the world is yours. South Bronx. The world is yours. Wow, that was really cool.
Yeah?
That's a cool song. Yeah, it's like... is it the chorus and that percussion and that the sound is going to keep going through my head for a while, I think.
Yeah, really, you know? Really catchy. Yeah. The world is yours.
So what's that all about?
Yeah,
then?
Well, it's sort of a reference to Scarface.
The movie?
Yeah, the movie.
Oh, okay.
Because I believe...
Scarface.
I watched it a long time ago, but I believe...
I saw it when it came out in 1980.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Was it 80?
I think it was 80. Wow. Yeah. Pacino was great in that. But anyway.
Yeah. I believe his motto is "The world is yours," or "Was the world is yours," and it's on like the blimp.
Oh, I don't.
That's
remember.
Sort of been parodied a lot of times with other writing, but that's where that reference comes from.
Oh, yeah.
And Scarface is a reference that comes up a ton in rap music. Absolute ton.
Really?
To this day.
I noticed he talks about his son. My strength is my son. All the wrong shit I did, he'll lead in the right direction.
Mm-hmm.
So he's got, maybe he's hoping his son won't get so involved in some of the stuff he was possibly involved in.
Yeah, he's trying to pave a good, healthy way for not only his son, but the people in his community.
Yeah.
Well, one important lyric is... I'm out for presidents to represent me.
Oh, yeah.
Say what?
Darn it, I was going to mention that. Yeah, say what?
Yeah.
When they say what? It's like I'm thinking they're saying, what are you talking about, Naz? Presidents representing you? How could they possibly represent you? They're in their ivory tower. They don't represent the people. Is that?
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah,
exactly.
Yeah,
and that's that same idea is reinforced by the final line when he repeats that two times, right?
Yep.
I'm out for presidents to represent me. And he finally says, I'm out for dead presidents to represent me. And the reason why he says...
Yeah, why dead?
Dead presidents is because the people in office aren't doing a good enough job to champion what he cares about. So the thing he resorts to is dead presidents, people that have faces on money, on the bills. So that's why he's out here trying to get some dead presidents, just like Rakim said in his in a song that I made you react to.
Oh, that's yeah.
So there's a connection there, yeah.
Okay, so the president, right. So he wants presidents to represent him. They don't. So given that being a fact, never changing fact, I guess,
because
he repeats it, he decides, I'm just going to go after money. I got to look after myself.
Yeah.
Screw them. They're not going to help me out here.
Totally. Uh-huh. Totally.
Yeah.
It's ironic.
That's great.
Yeah, it's ironic how people that are dead... do more for him in that sense than the people that are in office, right?
Yeah, that, yeah.
It's a pretty stark realization.
Yeah, yeah. It's nice how we put those two together. Mm-hmm. Presidents and, dead presidents. Very smartly done.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Writing in my book of rhymes, all the words past the margin. I just love that.
I think I, understand what he's saying there. So he's a rapper, and he's so into his writing. Mm-hmm. Is this right?
Yeah.
That he's got so much to say that he actually goes, you know, usually when you're writing, you write to the end of, till you come to that margin and you stop. But he just keeps going. He fills every page.
Yeah. And the funny thing is that he could fill every page by following the conventions of writing in a book.
Yes.
Right. He could just write on the one page and then move on to the next page. Yes. But he just cannot stop.
Yeah.
He's going across.
Yeah. Yeah.
So the conventionality of writing is thrown out the window because, So this next song is called Halftime. And on the record, as you can see here, it's the last song on the first side. So it quite literally signals the halftime of the album.
Okay.
So I find that placement sort of just trivial, but mm-hmm. funny and interesting. Mm-hmm. And this is the first single that Nas released for Illmatic in 92.
Okay. So this actually was his first single ever then?
Yeah. It was released on the Zebra soundtrack, which was a movie that's sort of like a romantic thriller.
Okay. Great.
And
well, that would be exciting for him getting this out on a soundtrack at such a young age.
Yeah.
Ooh, heavy bass.
Yeah.
Check me out, y'all.
Bass lines on this album are all different.
I've noticed that. I've noticed
in tone, rhythm, and speed.
Before a blunt, I take out my fronts. Then I start the front. Matter of fact, I'll be on a manhunt. You couldn't catch me in the streets without a ton of reefer. That's like Malcolm X catching a jungle fever. Ain't a damn thing gonna change. I'm a performer, strange show. The mic warmer was born to gain. Nas, why did you do it? You know you got the mad fat fluid when you rhyme. It's halftime.
I wonder if that's his dad. Plays a trumpet, you said?
Yeah, yeah, he does. I don't know. I didn't hear it was, but it could be.
Yeah.
And next time I rhyme, I'll be foul. Whenever I freestyle, I see trial. Niggas say I'm wow. I hate a rhyme, fight his rhyme. Stay tuned, I assume the real rap comes at halftime.
Cymbals throughout the entire song.
I don't hear
and
them.
And a constant rhythm.
Oh yeah.
Yeah. Throughout the entire song. It's less noticeable in the chorus. I love how the horns come in randomly throughout the song sometimes.
They're fantastic.
Flip a morning song every afternoon. I kick half the tune, and in the darkness, I'm heartless like when the knocks hit. Word the Marcus Garvey, your heartless sparked it. Cause when I blast the herb, that's my word. I be slaying them fast, doing this, that, and the third. But chill, Pastor Andre, and let's lay. I bag bitches up at John Jay and hit a matinee. Enough props, enough clout. Ill Will, rest in peace, yo, I'm out.
Ill Will was his childhood friend.
Oh, he's dead. Yeah. Again, he's paying homage to places and people there.
Yep. In every song.
Yeah, this was a cool one.
Yeah.
They're all cool. Yeah. They're all a bit different, and the instrumentation is all very interesting and effective. So here, let me see if I got this right.
Yeah.
He's now talking more, less about the life of trying to get by on the streets and hustling with his crew and his guys and stuff. And it's more about the rap, right?
Yeah, this is him. It's his first single.
He's bragging about being one heck of a rapper.
Yeah.
Basically, right?
Yeah. So he's wanting to put himself on the map.
Yeah.
And make people realize that he's one to look out for.
Yeah. Yeah.
So that's the purpose of the song.
Uh-huh. Uh-huh. I'm a Nike head, so he loves his shoes.
Yeah.
Right? I wear chains that excite the feds. I like that line. Like, maybe he's got so much on him that the feds are looking at him. Huh, where'd this guy get his money? Or exactly. What's up with this guy, right?
Yeah, it's a different type of excitement, though, than regular people looking at the chains.
Yeah.
But his flow's great. He's always switching it. I know flow's a difficult thing for you to grasp.
It really is. I'm doing my best, believe me.
So that was Halftime.
Yeah, nice.
Probably my least favorite song on the album. But still,
A good song.
Good song, nonetheless.
So there's nothing. There's no weak tune on this album.
Not
in your eyes.
Not at all.
Okay.
Not at all. It's all. Halftime, I think, is a good song. Not much more. Although, DJ Premier, who produced songs in this album, I believe he produced New York State of Mind, which was the second song. He heard Halftime and thought, "Oh shit, this kid is amazing. I gotta work with this guy."
Oh wow!
And he did, which is great. Yeah. But he even said he thought that even if he didn't make any money from working with this kid, that he just needed to. He spotted his brilliance early on.
Did he really?
And so did other people. There are a lot of legendary producers on this album, like DJ Premier. He's really well known for scratching. Q-Tip.
That sounds funny to me.
Scratching.
Yeah, I'm well known for scratching an album. Yeah, but it involves a lot of technique, I guess.
Oh, tons, yeah.
Yeah.
You can have your own style.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Even one song that Kanye released recently, right? Oh, actually, one song that Kanye released in 2007 called Everything I Am. He was done the song, and he called up DJ Premier at 4 in the morning and says, "Yo, man, can you scratch on my record?"
Yeah.
He's just like, "Yeah, sure."
Yeah.
He got up, did it.
No way.
Sent it back.
No way.
Yeah.
That's funny.
Yeah.
Jeez.
It's a talent, although I don't know much about it.
Yeah.
But you can tell that some people are better than others, and some people have their own particular style. Yeah. You know when it's a DJ Premier track.
Are you serious?
You know.
From the type of scratching?
Yes.
Wow.
You can create melodies with the scratching like no one else can, in my opinion.
That just amazes me.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
No.
So this is the sixth song. We're getting onto the second half of the album.
Okay.
Called Memory Lane.
Maybe about childhood, but we'll find out. Or you know, I'll find out.
Yeah. Okay. This is Memory Lane. Great song. I love this song. That shit. Word. Produced by DJ Premier.
You know, we're gonna do a little something like this. You know what I'm saying? Kind of funky organ going on. I haven't heard organ so far on this album.
Yeah, there hasn't been. Grand Wizard. What is it like? You know what I'm saying?
Heard of me?
Those vocals in the background. I rap for listeners, blunt heads, fly ladies, and prisoners, Hennessy holders, and old school niggas. Then I'll be dissing the unofficials that mo woolly tie. I dropped out of coolie high, gas the bar, coquette, cutie pie, jungle survivor, fuck who's the lava. My man put the battery in my back, a difference from energizer. Sentence begins to dent it with formality, moderation's infinite, money wise, a physiology. It's like that, y'all. It's like that, y'all. Peace God is a commonly used greeting for 5%ers.
Peace God.
Yeah. 5% is talking about a new rocking video.
Yeah.
So this Now Let Me Take a Trip Down Memory Lane. That's a sample from Biz Markie, who recently died last year. But he's really well known because he was the first rapper to really sing on a song.
The very first friend,
yeah. I rap the vanguard, check that prognosis. Is it real or showbiz? My window faces shoot out from overdoses. Live amongst the roses, only the drama. For real, a nickel plate is my fate. My medicine is the ganja. Here's my basis. My razor embraces many faces. Your telephone blown, black stitches of fatuations. That nigga's name may bell rings. Blacks of face cream. About supreme. I just love that organ.
Yeah. Uptown was
outpost, son. Heard he was. How about those background vocals, though? Right here. Watch the herbs stand still.
Never talking to snakes.
Oh, yeah.
Words a man kill. True in the game. As long as blood is blue in my vein. I pull my Heineken brew. To my deceased crew in memory lane.
Said I pour my. I know you missed these last lyrics.
Oh, I like those vocals, yeah.
I pour my Heineken brew to my deceased crew in memory lane. Paying homage to those that have passed away.
Yeah. Yeah, I like this one overall. Maybe not quite as much as the other ones.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
How come?
I don't know. Well, I love the music, but I didn't quite catch on to the meaning of the lyrics as much.
Right.
I mean, I understand certain lines, but the overall.
This one has has some more references to things that are more in his culture.
Okay.
That are.
Yeah,
harder to understand.
Yeah, he seems to like grass. He likes smoking grass. I'm guessing woolly tie is grass.
And woolly tie?
Yeah, unofficial that smoke, then I be dissing.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Anyway, there's some mentions of grass.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah. I think though that woolly tie, that might be like slang for things that weed that's laced with something else.
Okay. Could be, yeah.
No sign of the beast in the blue Chrysler.
Yeah, so that just sign means... of the beast, the devil. The sign of the the beast, the devil. So what's
he talking exactly. So the mark of the beast, that's the devil.
Yeah.
And he's relating that to how he and his posse sees the police.
Okay. Blue Chrysler, blue car.
Yeah.
Blue Chrysler. Okay.
So they're saying there's no sign of the beast, the devil, in blue Chrysler, which is just police. Mm-hmm. I guess that means peace.
I guess so. Everything's okay. Everything's cool. Everything's calm at the moment.
Except he says, "I guess that means peace." So he's not sure because they can pull up on you at any time, right?
Yeah.
So I think that's a really important word that he slips in there.
Yeah. That reminds me really, really fast of that the one Ice Cube song I've listened to. It was a good day. Where he's talking about, you know, the cops aren't up there in their helicopters.
Yeah.
Everything's, so I guess it's a good day sort of thing, you know.
Yeah,
so this constant awareness of where are the cops relative to me right now,
mm-hmm.
right?
Yeah.
Which is something I never, ever have to consider, ever.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. I think that goes without saying.
Yeah. Yeah.
Unless there's something we don't know about.
Well, I have had one or two run-ins with the police, but we're not going to go...
Why, you called them up because of a noise disturbance or something?
No. I haven't been a goody-two-shoes all my life, you know.
Yeah.
I wouldn't be normal if I hadn't, you know, done one or two things I maybe shouldn't have, right?
Yeah, well, I guess that's a bit different than getting the proper sort of attention from the police instead of being looked at all the time.
Yeah. Totally, totally different. Yeah. Some of these loops are just so catchy, man.
Yeah.
Right?
Hypnotic.
You just want to sit back with a Hennessy or a, you know, sure, a 40 spliff.
Ounce of malt liquor or something.
Yeah. Or a spliff, you know, something, and just sit back and just listen to that. I could just listen to it without the lyrics even.
Yeah. These beats are good enough just to be heard without anything else. I'd probably
it makes me want to hear the sample. That's a sample?
Yeah.
I want to hear the sample it came from.
Mm-hmm.
Do you know?
No. I don't. I'm
okay,
sorry.
You guys, let us know where that really cool organ sample came from, please.
This one's a great one.
Word is born, you got 6 minutes on that jack, kid. That shit is real.
Hey, yo, check this shit out, man.
Hey, yo, go, give me a cigarette, man.
Yo, here you go, here you go, here you go. Check it out, man. Check out what I got here, man.
What is that? What's that?
Yo, it's a letter I got from my man Nas, man. Word is born.
What it say, kid?
What up, kid? I know shit is rough doing your bit. When the cops came, you should have slid to my crib. Fuck it, black, no time for looking back is done. Plus, congratulations, you know you got a son. I left for half a hundred in your commissary. You was my nigga when push came to shove.
One what?
One love.
One love. One love. One love. One love. One love.
So this is the tip on the chorus here.
That's a very unusual chorus. It's so simple.
Yeah, a lot of the courses are simple like this, just repeating one sort of, you know, the world is yours.
So stay civilized, time flies, go incarcerated, your mind dies. I hate it when your mom's cries.
Like
it kinda makes me want to murder, for real. I even got a mask and gloves to bust slugs, but one love.
One love, one love, one love, one love.
This bass line is a lot more complicated and more avant-garde than the previous stuff, I think.
I like that. Is it a vibraphone?
Yeah, it's a vibraphone.
Yeah. It's nice. Nice contrast to that bass.
Sometimes I sit back with a Buddha sack. Mine's in another world thinking how can we exist through the facts. To my man Lake Luciano.
I like this one a lot.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Can't forget my motherfucking heart. Big bro. One love.
Kick drum is massive.
Yeah, I love the percussion there.
Yeah,
I like the contrast of that deeper bass drum and then the higher vibraphone. It was nice.
I think that Q-Tip produced this, and that it, you can tell that if you were to listen to this album, someone told you Q-Tip produced one song,
yeah,
that would be the song.
Really?
It's a lot more relaxed.
yeah,
and spacious than the other songs.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I got that that feeling from it for
and
sure.
It's like playful with the vibraphone. I really like it. Mm-hmm. And the bass is a little bit different.
Mm-hmm. Well, the subject matter, him talking to these friends of his, you know, where he's telling what's going on. I think that sound goes well with what he's saying. You know, mm-hmm. It's more a bit more laid back, right? Yeah, yeah. I like the song. I like some of the lyrics. I like the sentiment, right? He's taking the time to actually write to these people.
Yeah.
It starts right off, right? And he says, what's up, kid? I know shit is rough doing your bid. When the cops came, you should have slid to my crib. You should have come to my place. But fuck it, Black. No time for looking back. It's done. Plus, congratulations. You know you got a son.
Yeah.
So he's telling the guy stuff he doesn't know. He's got a son, and he doesn't even know that. You know. And then later on, towards the end of this first verse, he says, I put $50 in the commissary for you because you were my buddy. And when we face tough situations, you help me out. So I'm helping you out. Yeah, I like that.
Mm-hmm. Second verse, it has the lines, I hate it when your mom dies. It even kind of makes me want to murder for real. I even got a mask and gloves to bust slugs, but one love.
Yeah. Yeah,
so he's powerful. So frustrated with the situation, even though he's looking after this this guy's mom.
Mm-hmm. Before that, he says, so stay civilized.
Yeah.
Like, time flies. Like, you know, just you got to persevere in there. I know it's tough.
He says he'll play it low key till he comes home.
Yeah. I really like this line, guy. He said, I had to school them. Told them, don't let the N-word, don't let people fool him. Because when the pistol blows, the one that's murdered be the cool one. So, you know, if you blow someone away, you're not cool, man. That's not a cool thing to do.
Yeah.
The person you killed is the one who, well, you know, who's cool or, you know.
Has more integrity, I guess.
Yeah.
Not necessarily because they've been killed, but just because you're the one doing the killing.
Yeah, yeah. I like that series of lines a lot.
Yeah, that's really good.
Yeah. Yeah. But, you know, if you're 12 years old and you're, you know, you don't have money, you're kind of destitute, you're not doing well in school, partly because the schools aren't funded well enough. They don't provide any sort of incentive or stimulation for you, maybe.
Mm-hmm.
You're going to turn to these guys you see on the street corners and these guys who are strutting guest jeans or just dressed to the hilt, right? These are going to be your role models. But he's trying to tell them that, you know, you got to look for something else.
Yeah.
Right. Is this the second last or?
This is the third last.
Third last. Okay. Produced by Large Professor.
Yep. Large Professor.
It's a funny name.
Yeah. Large Professor is a really close friend of Nas's and worked with him really early on and helped get a lot of these legendary producers. One Time for Your Mind.
Yep. Ooh, it's kind of a dissident.
Yeah, it's Illmatic.
It makes me think of when the bar comes down at the train track so you can't cross.
You know? Yeah.
One time for your mind, one time. Yeah, whatever. One time for your mind, one
rumbly
time.
Rumbly bass line.
One time for your mind, one
time.
Hey, yo, nah. What up, pick that fucking rhyme. Check it out. When I'm chillin', I grab the Buddha, get my crew to buy beers and watch a flick, illin' and root for the villain, huh? Plus every morning I go out and love it sorta chilly, then I send a shorty from my block to the store for Phillies. After being blessed by the herb's essence, what? I'm back to my rest, 2 minutes, some odd seconds, yeah. One time for your mind, one time, yeah, whatever. One time.
So this is Grand Wizard and Nas on the chorus here. Grand Wizard is a legendary DJ who was the first one to do scratching.
Oh.
Right, what up, niggas? How y'all? Is Nasty the villain? I'm still writing rhymes, but besides that, I'm chilling. Never plan to stop when I write, my hand is hot. And expand a lot from the Wiz to Camelot. The parlayer, I make your heads bop, paw. I shine a light on perpetrators like a cop's car. From day to night, I play the mic and you'll thank God. I wreck shit so much the microphone and need a big job. My brain is
That's
incarcerated.
Yeah.
Live at any jam, I couldn't count all the blocks I rated. A whole of Mac 11 and attack a reverend. I contact 11 L's and Macs in heaven. Yo. One time for your mind, one time.
This is really cool.
Yeah. It almost sounds hazy.
Mm-hmm. I don't know what I would call it, but...
Any particular lines that stick out to you?
I try to stay mellow rock. Well, a cappella rhymes will make me richer than a slipper made Cinderella.
Fella.
So, as he's talking about Cinderella, I thought it's funny how you suddenly Cinderella, this story about this, you know, white girl scrubbing floors, and then she gets this slipper and she has this life of, you know,
yeah,
wonderful life. So, is he saying there that is, I think he may be saying that he does rhyme. He rhymes so well that he's going to become rich.
Yeah.
Maybe, or he's foreseeing the future or something.
An unexpected route to fame sort of thing.
Yeah. Yeah. Being blessed by the herb's essence.
I like that.
I like that too. From day to night, I play the mic and you'll thank God. I wreck shit so much, the microphone will need a paint job. Yeah, that's great. He's just boasting, man. I am so hot. Whenever I think of that sort of bragging about how great you are, I always think back, and I was going to say, sorry, guys, I mentioned him before, but Cassius Clay Muhammad Ali, you know, how he used to do those, that rhyming boasting when he faced another opponent, like Joe Frazier. I'm the greatest. And he'd trash his opponents to their faces prior to a match. And a lot of people in the white community, I think, I remember... My dad telling me that a lot of people, not my dad, he loved Ali, but really,
yeah, no, yeah,
and he loved Cassius Clay. But anyway, that a lot of people found his way, they found him rather vulgar and overly confident, overly boastful. And I think it was partly because of his race, I think. But I don't know if it was because of Ali, but... as far as I recall, Ali, you know, kind of started that trend in a way. And now I think a lot of rappers boast and brag about stuff. And some athletes do, right?
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah, yeah. So, yeah, that's all I wanted to say. And so does Nas in the song. He shows his confidence, how great he is at what he does.
Yeah.
Which is, you know, a good thing to do, really, when you think about it.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
That's a good observation.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Definitely some similarity there. I wonder if that was sort of the start of it or not.
Yeah, I have no idea.
Yeah.
But in my life, Ali was the first person I can recall seeing on TV behaving that way. And it was quite like, whoa, listen to this guy, what he's saying.
Mm-hmm.
You know?
We're coming to the end here.
Okay.
It's called Represent.
So I've got a feeling maybe with this title Represent, he feels he represents his borough or his place. I don't know if it was a borough, but... So maybe this song is about him saying that I represent my community or something like that. I like that keyboard.
Yeah. So that's he chopped that up and created that melody. That's his own melody.
Oh, it sounds like older school rap. So they just kind of shout out something.
Uh-huh. Is the hot spot full of mad criminals who don't care, nuzzling beers, we all stare at the out-of-towners. They better break north before we get the four-pounders and take their face off. The streets is filled with undercovers, homicide chasing brothers, the D's on the roof trying to watch us and knock us, pulling the tech out the dresser. Police got me under pressure.
Kind of bops along.
Yep, totally.
Always on the corner, rolling up blessed. When I dress, is never nothing less than guests. Your brain on drugs, to all fly bitches and thugs. Enough respect to the projects, I'm ghost, one love. Represent, yo, represent, yo, represent.
Every time I hear this beat, I think of how it just sounds so fresh still, even listening today.
It's really crisp.
To everybody in New York that's living a real fucking life.
He said that with a lot of conviction.
I love how they put the echo on it.
Any day, right at the beginning, any day could be your last in the jungle. Get murdered on a humble guns oblast. N-word tumble. People tumble. The corners is the hot spot, full of mad criminals who don't care, guzzling beers. We all stare at the out-of-towners.
And they go, hey, yo, who that?
Yeah, yeah. Like they're all standing around in the street corner, hanging out. And then some stranger walks by who they don't know. And he's going, hey, Nas, who's that dude? Right? Yeah, it's very visual. Uh-huh. You just picture it. I feel like I'm on the street with these guys right now, somehow, you know?
Oh, totally has that atmosphere.
Yeah.
Which helps with the additional voices. You know, mm-hmm. if it was just Nas's voicing, represent, and didn't have this little sound, this little voice.
Yeah.
And clips.
The voices at the beginning of him hanging out with his buddies, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. And then it bops along. It's cool. It's like a street sound. They're on the street, you know? I really like that.
Mm-hmm.
And also this part, the street is filled with undercovers, homicide chasing brothers, the D's on the roof trying to watch us and knock us, and killer cops even come through in helicopters. So again, just that reference to what it's like on the street, right? He's got, he's got
to watch out for anything.
The police are chasing him, and also homicide chasing brothers. So other people... who are actually not cops, but he's got to watch out for them. So he's hanging out, but he's also, you know, got his eyes and ears out, right?
Mm-hmm. It ain't hard to tell.
Mm-hmm.
Produced by Large Professor. And if you think of hip hop as, or good rap in hip hop music as an equation of adding a good beat
mm-hmm.
and good rapping,
mm-hmm.
this is the song.
Okay. They really, really work well together. They're totally in harmony in a sense.
Yeah.
All right.
And they're just both amazing in their own right.
Hope I can catch that.
Yeah.
We'll see.
Let's
have it going. Ain't hard to tell.
It ain't hard to tell.
I like that opening. And that off key kind of sax.
Yeah, that's amazing.
And the shout. Some shouting going on there. So.
Yeah, right there.
Hey!
I think he's saying.
Yeah.
James Brown, I believe.
It ain't hard to tell.
Sounds
I excel, like then prevail. The mic is contacted, I attract clientele. My mic check is life or death, breathing the sniper's breath. I exhale the yellow smoke of Buddha through righteous steps, deep like the shining. Sparkle like a diamond, sneaker Uzi on the Allen, and my army jacket lining hit the earth like a comet invasion. Nas is like the Afrocentric Asian, half man, half amazing. I leave him froze like heroin in your nose. Nas, I rock well, it ain't hard to tell.
There's no... Of course, we both talk at the same time. There's no hook during this song.
Oh, wow.
There's no chorus.
Yeah.
It's just the music.
Well, this is a hook in and of itself.
Yeah, musical. There's so much going on.
This rhythmatic explosion is what your frame of mind has chosen. I leave your brain stimulated. Niggas is frozen. Speak with criminal slang. Begin like a violin. End like Leviathan is deep. Well, let me try again. Wisdom be leaking out my grapefruit truth. I dominate break loops. Giving Mike's ministry cycles. Streets disciple. I rock beats this mega trifle. And groove even smoother than moves by Villanova. You're still a soldier. I'm like Sly Stone and Cobra. Packing like a Rasta in the weed spot. Vocals are squeezed Glocks. MCZs drop. Though they need not to sneak. My poetry's deep. I never fail. Nas's rap should be locked in a cell. It ain't hard to tell.
Yeah, I love every aspect of the music.
Yeah.
The combination of instruments.
Yeah. One of, kind of got closer. Yeah. One of the greatest beats of all time.
Yeah.
Actually.
Oh. Yeah. I love it. My mic check is life or death, breathing a sniper's breath.
I exhale the yellow smoke of Buddha through righteous steps.
Yeah.
I love that. I love how he opens with that. It's amazing.
Uh-huh. Yeah. Hit the earth like a comet invasion, like a comet, eh?
Yeah, that's, well, think.
He explodes with so much importance and...
finesse
and
everything.
Yeah.
That's what this album was at the time, right? This would have been I can't even imagine when this released. It only sold 60,000 copies the first week, which was a little bit under what was expected. Nas is like an Afrocentric Asian, half man, half amazing. So Nas...
Yeah, I didn't quite get that.
...uses a lot of 5%er lingo, mm-hmm. which we talked about already with Rocket.
Yeah, we did.
And they believe that the true original people of the earth come from the Asiatic African zone.
Mm-hmm.
The people that originated there are like the real people of Earth, the original people of Earth.
So that upper section of Africa.
Yes, I believe so.
Okay.
Uh-huh. And so...
Northeast.
Yeah, because okay. These are the original people, 5%ers think that they are part gods and part human because they have so much wisdom and are enlightened like a god,
mm-hmm.
but are also have a human side. The sort of, yeah, just the human side.
Yeah.
The mortal side, sorry. That's
what
I meant.
The mortal side, yeah.
So he's saying that he's sort of like half God, half man,
mm-hmm.
like what 5%ers consider the enlightened people to be. Well, enlightened people that want to share their knowledge, so the 5%.
I see. Right? Mm-hmm. Right.
So that's an iconic line.
Is it? People know that line.
Yeah, totally.
Right. Cool.
Well, okay. Well, since we talked about this track, what do you think of the whole album?
It's great. Yeah, I like it. I really feel like I'm getting, it's my first rap album. I feel like I'm coming away with a real sense of who he is and what goes on and has gone on in his life.
Mm-hmm.
Things that have pulled him this way or that way, challenges he's faced. Living in Queensbridge,
yeah,
and the friendships he's formed, the loyalties, the things that he has to watch out for. I'm just getting a feeling. I think I can't say it's for Queensbridge per se, but for somebody growing up in this kind of a community, I'm getting a real sense of that. Mm-hmm. And I'm going back to the sound of the train on the train tracks. I really like that. I found that to be such a unique thing. And then, you know, it's like I was stepping across the tracks into his neighborhood. And then he carries you along with his experiences and his observations and what's going on in his life through the songs. I found, and then he's got that.
Yeah, it's great.
I feel like I've entered his world to a certain degree. And I'm there on the streets with him. You know?
Yeah, well, that's the objective of the album, I think, which is great.
Oh, that's
that
good.
You felt that.
Yeah, I do feel that way. And, you know, when I think back to a lot of the rock albums I used to listen to, not just rock, I've listened to other types. I like other types of music, but I don't always get that sense from an album.
Mm-hmm.
It's like, it's a collection of good songs, but that's it, sort of thing.
Yeah.
So this is different from a lot of that. It's interesting the way they have all these producers. Like in rock music, there'd be one producer per album.
Mm-hmm.
I think there were a few albums where a producer would leave halfway through in disgust or for whatever reason, they bring someone on to finish it.
Yeah.
Maybe. No, I think they used to start over again.
Oh, yeah?
More often with a different producer.
Mm,
yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. But...
Well, yeah, this is completely different.
The role of the producers would be quite limited, right?
Yeah. Yeah, with hip-hop producers, they take on a massive role.
Yeah, I'm getting that impression.
Because they make the music.
Yeah.
Right? So when you have an album like this, you have five producers.
Yeah.
All putting in their input. They're sort of like band members for
that's the
album.
Impression
that's
the impression I'm
getting. Illmatic, yeah.
Yeah. Totally, right?
Mm-hmm.
And that wouldn't happen when I think of some of the rock producers. They'd maybe bring their ability in, and maybe a certain producer might be known for softening up a sound or making a sound a bit rougher or something. But it was by and large the band that created the sound.
Right.
You know, the producer would be quite secondary.
Yeah.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
Not so in rap, eh?
No, yeah. Not at all.
Yeah.
They don't really get their flowers. Well, I'm glad you liked the album.
Yeah, this was a really good intro to a full album reaction.
Nice.
And, you know, I gave it my best shot. I know I missed a lot of stuff. If you got any other input, stuff you can tell us about this album, you know, we do try and read as many of the comments as we can. So that would be really helpful too.
Yeah. Thanks for watching this reaction to Illmatic, everybody. And we'll see you soon.
Yeah. Come back soon, guys. Bye-bye.
Bye.